Depression is the most serious of all psychiatric disorders. It's the one of the most common medical conditions. It affects at least 5% of the population and is a global problem that impacts not just on mental health, but on physical health also. We know that patients with major depression who are chronically ill have higher rates of cardiovascular disease and other illnesses as well. We were interested in my lab in knowing how or if the microbiota in the gut played any role in the genesis of depression. So we took a large group of patients who were attending my clinic, and we took a group of healthy controls who were age and sex matched. And we profiled the gut microbiota in both groups. And to our surprise, we found that the gut microbiota in the depressed patients had a decrease in diversity and richness. So there were less microbes in the gut of patients with major depression. We then did an interesting study, and again, the results of this were very counterintuitive and anything but expected. We did a transplant of the microbiota from our depressed patients into rats. We also did a transplant into another group of rats of a microbiota from healthy individuals. And what we found, to our surprise, was transplanting the microbiota from a depressed patient into a rat resulted in depressive-like behaviour in the rat emerging. That did not happen when the rat had a transplant from a healthy individual. But not only did their behaviour alter, their tryptophan metabolism altered, and they developed features of inflammation. CRP, which is an important acute phase protein, went up. That is elevated in depression. And when the rats received the transplant from depressed patients, their CRP rose. So transplanting from a depressed patient to a rodent produced behavioral changes and changes not just in biochemistry, but in immunology also. So the big question, I suppose, really is, can we target the microbiota in order to treat depression? Now, our current view is very simple, that we should use, apart from antidepressants and any psychological therapy, we should give patients with depression dietary advice. And the dietary advice we give to depressed patients is to go on a Mediterranean type diet with a lot of fruit and vegetables, a lot of fish, and to restrict the intake of red meat. And we believe that this is the best way of promoting increased diversity and increase or make more rapid the healing process in recovering from depression.